Dear all, in the previous class we had a discussion on how we are going to apply ES bar TA algorithm on a single channel queuing system. Today we are going to discuss about the ES bar TA algorithm on double channel queuing system. First I will explain the scenario, then later we can discuss in detail with the diagram, and also we are going to solve one particular problem on this. Assume that there are 6 trucks are used to carry the coal or to shift that coal from one place to another place, and the initial conditions are given in the diagram 1. So here there are 2 different loaders. Here I can call these as servers, where in which every truck will be loaded by any one of these 2 loaders. After loading, okay, it has to be scaled or it has to be weighed. So loading the truck, after loading the truck will immediately move to scale. Okay, now the loaders and the scale are having first come first serve waiting line. Assume that after getting loaded, the time required to travel for scaling is considered as negligible. Okay, once the weighing is done, the truck will begin its travel time. It will unload the coal and again it will come back and join the loader queue. Okay, this is the scenario for this particular problem. Now we will see. If you look at the particular scenario, he has given as 6 tracks. I will call it as DT1, DT2, DT3, DT4, DT5, DT6. And in the scenario, it is given that one truck, that is first truck, is finished its loading part and it is getting scaled, or the scaling of or weighing of that particular DT1 is going on. So that is why it is on DT1. And another one, 2 different trucks, DT2, DT3, are getting loaded by using loader 1 and loader 2. L1 is loader 1, L2 is loader 2. So now 3 over. So another 3 are waiting, that is DT4, DT5 and DT6 are waiting for getting loaded. Okay, so now what, this is a waiting line for what loader, so hence it is called as loader queue. And here this is only for explanation part. After, say, assume that DT1 is getting scaled and the time required for the scaling is 10 minutes. Okay, DT1 will come out of this ES after 10 minutes. Now assume that this loader 1 will complete loading part of DT2 within 5 minutes. So what will happen? This DT2 will come here, but this is not free. So that means what, DT2 has to wait here. So then instead of DT, I will call it as DT2. So one is here at DT2, which has to wait for a certain period of a time till DT1 completes its scaling part. Okay, so this queue is called as weighing queue. Now DT1, after unloading, again it will start from here, it will come back and join the queue. So for coming from this place to this place, it requires a certain period of a time. That particular time is called as traveling time. Okay, so this is what the scenario is all about. Now there is one particular problem which is given that the loading time 5, 10, 5, 5, 10, 5, 10, 10. It does not mean that 3 plus 3, 6, 8 trucks are there. No, whichever will come first, L1 and L2, the time required for that is say 5 minutes. Another one is 10 minutes. In the given scenario, if you look at L1 and L2, DT1 and DT2, So DT1 will take 5 minutes, DT2 will take 10 minutes. Like that, these are the times. Weighing time, whichever comes first. So for that, it will take 12 minutes. Whichever comes for second, it will be for 12 minutes. I don't know whether it is DT1 or DT2 or DT3, depending on the condition which we are going to see in the problem. Now here, the traveling time is for what? Traveling for, like, after completing unloading part, it has to come back and join. So that is what the traveling time. So now it is here, it is 80. Okay. Now for this particular problem, you have to generate one scenario or simulation table. So here the end of the simulation is arrival of some truck to the loader queue after finishing its travel time. So here only you will come to know, like, how long you are supposed to carry out this particular problem. So now time t, so with this particular table, can you guess? That is, loader time, first one is 12 minutes. It is going to complete its weighing time 12 minutes. Okay. After weighing only, it will start traveling. So that is 12 minutes. 80 minutes is required for traveling. So 12 plus 80, that is 92 minutes. Till 92 minutes, it has to, you have to find out the simulation table. Otherwise, he will only give here the simulation time t is equal to 60 or 70 or whatever. There you have to stop. Another one. Out of this, what you have to create? You have to create the simulation table and estimate loader and scale utilizations. So with this particular problem, what you need to find out, that is loader utilization, that is BL, total busy time of both the loaders from the time to time, t naught to t. BS is total busy time for the scale from 0 to t. So this is what you need to find out. Okay, so the same thing it is carried out here. Now any system, so when I am going to simulate a particular table, so you need to have a system state, all the details, loader queue details, weighing queue details, the list, and the system state. Okay, the system state contains 4 variables: LQ of T, L of T, WQ of T, W of T, where LQ of T indicates the number of trucks in the loader queue. Okay, LQ of T is number of trucks in the loader. L of T is the number of trucks, whether it is 0 or 1 or 2, maximum will be what? 2. Okay, that is number of trucks being loaded. WQ of T is the number of trucks which are in weighing queue. Okay, WT, number of trucks either 0 or 1. So how many number of trucks will be weighed? Either 0 number of trucks or 1 number of trucks. So that is why it is 0 and 1 being weighed, all at simulation time t. Every time t matters. So here L of t is equal to 0, 1 or 2, because there are two different loaders. So both, there may not be any trucks on the loader. In that case, it is 0. There might be only one truck in another loader. So that's why 1, and both of them may be loaded. So with this, this is what we'll call it as system state. So this you have to include in the problem. Okay, after finding out the system state, now I have to write the event notices where you are going to represent all this in FEL, that is future event list. The first one is ALQ, T, DTI, which indicates like dump truck I arrives at loader Q, ALQ, that is at time T, that is after unloading the particular coal, it will come back and rejoins the queue. So that is what we will call it as ALQ, T, DTI. Next, when it goes for loading, it has to complete its loading after some period. So this is what we will call it as dump truck I ends loading EL at time t is equal at time is equal to t. So that is what EL comma t comma dti. Now after loading, it will go for scaling, and it will take some time there for completing scaling part. So that we are going to take it as like EW of t comma dti. So that is drum truck I ends weighing time or scaling time. So there are these are all the event notices which you are going to represent in APL. Now there is another one, entities, which talks about the DT1, DT2 up to DT6. So six entities. Along with this, you can have two different loaders, L1 and L2, and one is scaling, that is scalar, scaling is, that is S. Now in the problem, I have to represent a list also which contains three parts, two parts. One is loader queue and weighing queue. Loader queues are the number of trucks which are read. So that is what here it is given. All trucks waiting to begin loading ordered on first come first served basis. And another one is a weighing queue, where all trucks to be weighed ordered from first come first served basis. So here also it is first come first served. Now activities, there are three different activities. One is loading, okay, another one is weighing, and last one is travel. So delays, where delays can occur, one is at the loader queue, another one is at scale. So that is what delay at loader queue and delay at scale. So this is the problem, the scenario which we have done, that is which I have explained. Now I have taken the complete solution I have shown in the next part of the video. Thank you. Dear students, today we are going to discuss how to apply ES bar PA algorithm on a double channel tuning system. So this is something called as a dumb trunk problem. Okay, so where you are going to use certain number of trucks in order to shift a pole from one place to another place. Okay, you are moving this. Then using sub number of trucks. Okay, so that is why it is called as dumb truck problem. Now the initial conditions or the scenario is something like this. You have to use six trucks, namely DT1, DT2, DT3, DT4, DT5 and DT6, and you have two loader machines, which is L1 and L2, which are loaders. Okay, loader which are L1, L2, and after loading you have to scale it, you have to weigh it, that is called as scaling. Okay, so this is what your condition is. Now it says that our DT1, truck 1, is already completed loading part and it is getting weighed, that is why it is on scaler. Then DT2 and DT3 are two different trucks which are getting loaded, and another three are DT4, DT5 and another one is DT6, which are waiting for getting loaded. So now this is a queue on loader side, so hence it is called as loader queue. Okay, so now after getting loaded, okay, so DT2 and DT3, they will come for scaling. But assume that the truck which is at scaling 1, it is not yet completed its work, but L1, DT2 and DT3 have completed their loading part, then this DT2 and DT3 have to wait for a certain period of a time till this DT1 completes that particular job. So this queue is called as weighing queue. This queue is called as weighing queue. Okay, so now this is the scenario. Now after this DT1 completes scaling, it will go and dump
that particular coal, then again it will come back to loaders. The time required for DT1 to come back and rejoin the queue is called as a travel time. Okay, now you have a travel time is required, travel time, then the time required to scale, so that is loading time, which is called as loading time, and another one is weighing time, so which is weighing time. So these three are important and which are given in the problem: time required to travel, time required to load L1 and L2, for DT2, DT3 in this case, and time required for scaling. Now this particular scenario, you have to record it or you have to mention in each and every problem, then it becomes very easy for you to continue with the problem. Now in the given problem, you are supposed to indicate, or in the given simulation table, you are supposed to indicate what is the loader time, what are the scaling time, what is the travel time, plus what is the loader queue status, then weighing queue status, what are those, all these details you have to indicate in simulation table. Okay, now always I will start with clock. I have to represent clock. Okay, then as you already know, I have to represent system state. System state, so which includes LQ of T, LS of T, then WQ of T and W of T. So this is your system state, where LQ of T is the total number of loaders which are in the queue, the number of servers to be scaled down at the server, that is LS of T, then WQ of T is the number of loaders at queue, weighing queue. So this is your first part. Then you should also mention the list, which is something called as list. Okay, so list contains, here you will be mentioning there are three number of assume that there are three number of trucks which are waiting in the queue, waiting in the queue. Now you have to, in the list part, you have to mention what are those, so which is called as LQ. Okay, LQ, and here I will write here weighing queue, weighing queue. Okay, this is one part. Next, another important part is FEEL, so that is future event list. Okay, now one more important point is BL and say BS. So busy time of loaders put together L1 and L2, and the scaling time which is required on scale. Now after this, there is one important column, so which is very useful. Now initial condition, what is given at time t is equal to 0, that is clock t is equal to 0, what is the condition? So now if you write without this particular diagram, it becomes very very difficult for you. So that is where you have to write this particular diagram. I will write it as a diagram where yes, in the initial conditions, what are those? L1, L2, then loader queue. Okay, so here it is DT1, so here it is DT, I will take it as DT2, DT3, DT4, DT5, and say DT6. So this is what the initial condition is given. Now based on this, I can write that the LQ of T, that is loader queue, how many are there? 1, 2, 3. So this is loader cube. At this point of time, this is vehicle. So now there are three number of loads. Then how many number of loaders at the service, that is who are getting service, that is L1 and L2, which is 2. Is there any truck in the weighing cube? No, there is, it is 0. Now WT is how many number of getting completed, so it is also 0. WT is also 0. Now loader cube, you have to write down 3. What are these 3? So that is DT4, DT5, and you say it is DT6. Weighing cube, there is nothing as of now. Now future event list. So if you look at the, in the given problem, loading times are given. For DT2 is 5, for DT3 is 10. So event list are end loading time of DT2 at time t is equal to 5, end loading time of DT3 and say 10. Okay. And another one is EW, end waiting time of DT1 is given in the problem, that is 12 minutes. Okay. Now these are all your future events. Now how much time the server loaders are busy together? At clock time t is equal to 0, again it is 0 only. How much time the loader, the scaler is busy? It is 0. Now this is your first step. Now what is the next event? Next event is going to occur at the time t is equal to 5. So that is event is at t is equal to 5. Now at t is equal to 5, okay, what will happen? End loading of this particular event will be completed. So now what would be the condition? Write down this yes, whether DT1 will be there or not. Definitely yes, because this will be completed after 12 minutes. So we are at still 5, t is equal to 5. So now, okay, L1, say L2. At clock t is equal to 5, so what will happen? L1 will complete its loading part, and after loading it will come for weighing. So this will complete at t is equal to 12, hence this DT2 will wait for certain period of time. Now so this DT2 place is vacant till time t is equal to now this is vacant. So now DT3 will be here till time t is equal to 10, because end loading of DT3 is 10 minutes. So now this is free. So once it is free, one of these three will come based on first come first serve. So here DT4 is in first, so this DT4 will take place at this point of time. So now remaining is DT5 and another one is say DT6. Okay. So now this is your weighing queue, this is waiting queue, and this is your loader queue at this particular point of time. Okay. Now if you write down, at the time t is equal to 5, loader queue you have 2, okay, then servers you have 2, WQ, that is DT4, and this is also 1. Now if you look at loader queue, you have DT5 and say this is DT6. Weighing queue you have DT6. Now at this point of time, you write down what are the future events. Future events are 10 and 12 by default, EL of DT3 at 10, EW of DT1 completes at 12. Next, another one, EL of DT4. So if you look at the loading time, third time is 5 minutes. Okay, loading time required for DT4 is 5 minutes. From this 5 minutes, another 5 minutes. So 5 plus 5. Okay. So now what would be the loader busy time? So till this 5 minutes for one loader. So this is another load. There are two different loaders. So that is why it is 5 plus 5. Now scaling time or weighing time is only 5 bits. Okay, now I think you understood. Now, at clock time t is equal to 10, okay, so at time t is equal to 10, so S1 still it will be there because this computes at time t is equal to 12. So DT2 is already in the waiting queue. At time t is equal to 10, DT3 is going to complete at 10, and DT4 is also going to complete at t is equal to 10. So now these two will complete. So in that case, so DT3, okay, will complete. Then later DT4 also will complete the loading part. So now at this point of time, the loader L1 and loader L2 are free. So that means these two will come here. So DT5 and say DT6. So now this is your waiting queue. There is no queue in the loader side. So now at this point of time, loader queue 0, waiting queue, that is sorry, LSFT is 2, which is DT5 and DT6. Now WQ of T is 3, that is this one, and this is 1. Now LQ of T, you don't have anything. Waiting queue, you have 2, 3, 4. I'll write DT2, DT3, and DT4. Okay, now what are the future events? At clock time t is equal to 10, if you look at end loading time of this 5, DT5 is 15 minutes. Okay, then EL of end loading time of this DT6 is say 20. Then E weighing or end weighting of DT1 at a time t is equal to 5. Now if you look at till this part, at t is equal to 10, both servers are busy. So 10 plus say 10, which is equal to 20. And what about server? Server is busy, scalar is busy till time t is equal to 10. So this is the scenario at time t is equal to 10. Okay. Now the next event from the given previous step is at t is equal to 12. Okay. So now at t is equal to 12, what is the scenario? So now at t is equal to 12, at the scale S1, DT1 will complete its weight and it will come out. Okay. So now there was DT2 which is waiting in the queue, it will come for weight. And you have DT3 and DT4 which are in the queue, which are there in the queue. Now here you have L1 and L2 which are that is DT5 and DT6 are in the queue. Now what DT1 does is it will complete its weighing, scaling, and go and dump it. Again it will try to come back after some time, which is something called as a travel time. For this, travel time is given as 60. So that means it will come here after 12 minutes, so far it is done, plus another 60 minutes, that is after t is equal to 72 minutes it will come here. In the problem, what it is, they will ask is what is the time required. Now at this point of time, if you look at, there is no loader queue, that is 0. LS of T is say 2, WQ of 2 is 2, WQ of T weighing is already is 1. So with this, no LQ of T, weighing is waiting is DT3 and DT4. Now at time t is equal to 12, what are the future events? So it is in the given problem, the end time loading of DT5 is at t is equal to 15, then EL of DT6 is at 20, EW of DT2 is at T is equal to 12. If you want, you can write it or you can ignore that one also. Another one is something called as ALQ, arrival of the DT1 to the loader queue. Okay, so what is that? DT1, after how much time? Time is given as 80 minutes here. So 80 minutes from where? From T is equal to 12. So this is what your FEL for T is equal to 12. Now at this point of time, both the loaders are busy, so hence it is 12 plus 12, which is equal to 24. So now here it is 12. Now what is the next event in this particular part? So next time is, say T is equal to 15, I will take clock T is equal to 15. Again I will draw. So at DT2 is done now. So now at clock T is equal to 12 minutes. So that is from here it is 12 minutes. So one is DT1 is completed. From here again the scaling time for DT2 is 12 minutes. So 12 to 12 again. So that means it will be here only. That is okay. Yes, so here it is DT2. I have DT5 and DT6, which is going to complete at T is equal to 15. So now, okay, so now this DT5 has completed at T is equal to 15. So you will have DT3, DT4, and DT5. Okay, so nothing is there on L1. And this is LQ. Okay. Now with this, now I can write LQ, you don't have anything. LS of T is only 1. Okay. Vein Q, you have 3. WT is 1. Okay. So now this is nothing. You will have DT3, you will have DT4, and you will have DT5. What are the future events? So future events are end time of this. That is EL of DT26 at T is equal to 20, then EW of DT2, that is 12 minutes, that is from here it is 12 minutes, so here it is 24. Okay, 24, ALQ DT1 of 92. Okay. So now VL will be like 15 plus 15, which is equal to 30, and 15 minutes is a circle time. So next event is at T is equal to 20, T is equal to say 20. Okay. At this point of time, at T is equal to 20, your DT2 is still will be there because it is going to complete at T is equal to 24. So now yes. Will be DT2. You have L1 and you have say L2. If you look at here, L1 DT6. DT6 at T is equal to 20, it is going to complete its loading. So even this now it will also complete. So now at this point of time, DT3, DT4, DT5 and DT6. Will be waiting to get the service done. So you don't have anything now at L1 and L2. Now with this, LQ will be 0. LS of T again, now it is 0. No, nothing is there in the loader side. So now weighing Q, you have 4 different queues, that is different trucks. So WTF, now it is busy. So now LQ of T is nothing. You have DT3, DT4, DT5 and say DT6. So now this is, if you look at, I can write EW of at T. So I can write DT2, EW of DT2 at T is equal to 24. Then ALQ I can write DT1 at say 92. Even I can write EW of DT3 is at 36. From here, 24 EW of DT2, 24 EW is 36. Now here at this point of time, till this, the loaders are busy, but if you look at here, the L2 is still busy for another 5 minutes. So this is 30, both loaders were busy, and from here only DT2 was busy for 5 minutes, this is from 15 to 20 minutes, so which is 35, and the server is busy for another 5 minutes. So this is what at t is equal to 20, where EW at t is equal to 24. Stop. Now at t is equal to 24, what is the scenario? The scenario is T2 will complete its scaling part. Okay, so now you will have a S where DT3 will come here, and DT1 is already in move, and DT2 now it will join for retry. So travel time for that is also 18 minutes. Now you have L1 and say L2. Now if you look at DT3, DT4, DT5, DT6. DT3 has come here, left out with is DT4, DT5 and DT6. Okay. Now future events for this is end time of DT3, then EW of DT4, DT5, DT6 and ALQ of DT1 and ALQ of DT2 will be your future events that you can write down. Now with this, you don't have anything in the loader side, that is 0. Unless you have 0 at the service, nothing is there in L1 and L2. Weighing you have 3, that is D4, 5, 6, and 1 is this one. Now here, nothing is here. You will have DT4, DT5, and here it is DT6. So as I told, what are the end times? EW of DT3 is 12 minutes from here. So that is 36. Then ALQ of DT1 at 92. Then ALQ of DT2 is 80 minutes from here. So that means what? 180 plus 24. So it is 104. Okay. Now, so with this, another one I can write EW of DT4 is of 52 minutes. That also you can write it. From here 16 minutes, which is given in the problem. So now, till this. Okay. Now, what about loader busy time? Nothing. It is accumulative. Whichever I have taken previously, that is 35 minutes. So now here 35 minutes to 20 to 24 minutes, this server is also busy, 20 minutes less shift. So that is 24. The problem is end time is at t is equal to 24, then here you have to stop. But in the given problem, you have to stay till the back arrival time of after DT1 completes its scaling and come back to loader queue. So that is T is equal to 92, you have to find out till this. Now next T is equal to, next event is say 36. So with this, if you add T is equal to 36, if you look at this D3, you complete scaling part, it will again join the queue. So now here DT4 will come at this point of time, so you are left out with DT5 and say DT6. So here you have L1 and say L2. Now this is the condition. Now, if you look at this, this is 0, this is 0, you have 2, you have 1 as per this particular diagram. So, this is a DT5 and this is a DT6, which is given as per the diagram. So, now for this, REW of DT4 at t is equal to 52, ALQ of DT1 at 92, ALQ of DT4 at 104, then. So now T3 is also added to this. So in this you have DT1, DT2 and say DT4. So now I can also write ALQ of DT4, that is DT3, which is 136. Now at this point of time, again these are free, so it is 35 minutes. From this 12 minutes added, okay. So where the server is busy, so that is also is equal to 36. So now this is what at time t is equal to 36. Now next event, which is going to occur at 52 second minutes. If you look at 52nd minute, this GT4 also will complete its task. So your diagram will be like this. So you will have DT5, okay. So you will have DT5, okay. You will have only DT6 at this queue, and you are left out with L1 and L2. So DT4 also, DT3 will also join the queue. So this is DT1, DT2, DT3. So now you have DT1, DT2, DT3 and DT4. Like this you have to complete. Now with this, at this particular point of time, you have 0, 0, 1, 1. Okay. So now left out is only DT6. Okay, with this particular diagram. So for this, our future events are ALQ of these things of DT1 at 92, ALQ DT4 at 104, ALQ DT3 at 136, and another one is EW of DT5 at time t is equal to 60. Now with this again it is only 35. From here 36 to 52 minutes it is busy, so that is 36 plus 16, which is 52 minutes. Now at last stop. Continue the same, you will get next is 68 minutes, and draw the diagram, you will get 0, 0, 0, 1. Okay. For this is ALQ DT1 at 92, ALQ of DT2 104, then EW of DT6 at t is equal to 80. Now, from 52 to 68 minutes, there are no loaders, which is the same value. From that, if here 52 minutes earlier plus 12, which is 68 minutes. Similarly, at t is equal to 80 is the next one. So if you draw this diagram, you will get these values, where for this events are ALQ DT1 say 92, ALQ DT2 at 104. Okay, so this is what the next one. So now there are no loaders, 35 minutes, then 68 minutes earlier plus from there 12 minutes, which is 80 minutes. Okay, now finally we arrive at this point of time, that is the, you have to simulate a table till the first truck rejoins the particular loader queue, that is at t is equal to 92. If you look at here, you will get 0, 0, no values. Okay, then you, somewhere you have to stop here, where EL is of DT1, 92 minutes is at arrival time, another 5 minutes extra. So then EL of DT4 at 92 minutes, from here it is 10 minutes which is given in the problem. So this is 35, from again here just they have joined up. So this is what your the value is. Now the scale utilization is total 80 minutes. Okay, out of how much time? 92. So that is scale utilization is this is what value is BES, which is 0.8696. So this is how you are going to work out the dump truck problem. So I tried my level best to make you understand this. The detailed explanation is given in